Hi, I'm Kathleen Miranda. I am co-author of the second edition of Calculus, Early Transcendentals, published by Macmillan. As more and more students have been encouraged to go into STEM, they need to take calculus, and we wanted to write a book that students could succeed with. For 27 years, I taught math at State University of New York College at Old Westbury. I had many students that were very diverse, not only diverse in ethnic background, but in educational background, in abilities, and in interests. So I loved teaching students that were reluctant learners or students who thought they couldn't learn, they had low expectations. We wanted a book, and we strove to get a book that a student could read, understand, and succeed in. We supplemented all the definitions, the theorems, with margin notes, just-in-time review to bring them back, need to review or recall. Then we took the more difficult concepts and we wrote in words. When we wrote worked examples, we often annotated the solutions so students would know exactly what we were doing and where we were going and what we were coming from. The last thing we wanted was for a student to give up and say, I can't learn calculus. After most of the worked examples, we have a feature that says, now work problem, with a problem number from the exercises at the end of the section. And that was for twofold. It builds confidence. They now use the worked example and they can go and say, oh, I can do this. It also gives them immediate feedback. So if there's a chance they can't do the problem, they know to go back and review and try to learn what they had learned. An instructor can use our exercises either to check, did the student read the section, or they can be used for a quick quiz or discussion. Next come the skill building, and those are very extensive. They are scaffolded. They go from easy to more difficult. Most of them stay within the objective, and then there's a mixed practice at the end. After the skill building exercises, we have applications and extensions. These really tell, does the student understand and can the student apply what he's learned? We've tried to draw applications from many different fields. There are applications from finance and economics. There are applications from physics and chemistry and the other sciences and engineering. Finally, there are several challenge problems at the end of most of the sections. And these are made to be thought-provoking, may have drawn from material taught earlier in the course. We made an effort to, throughout the textbook, include more conceptual examples and exercises and explanations. By using very carefully chosen worked examples and with solutions that are annotated and include all the premises from the theorems and the definitions, that a student will develop an understanding of calculus and be able to then solve problems. Our goal is to prepare students for their chosen career. I always told my children, I always told my students, take as much math as you can and then do what you want to do. And that's how I'm looking at calculus. If one or two people love calculus the way, or math, the way Mike and I do, well, that's wonderful. And the book is there and will set them on their way. But for most students, calculus is just a roadblock in their path. We want them to remove it as a roadblock and make it a golden path so they succeed.